Good morning students, this is the second video of your first chapter. So in this video we'll discuss our very first topic, that is the French Revolution and the idea of nation. So when we look back to see the birth of nationalism, we can trace that it first started in France in 1789. I hope you remember the French Revolution. You have already read in class 9th. I hope you remember what happened on 14 July 1789, the immediate cause, the reaction of people and everything. Now coming back to nationalism, what is nationalism? So your nationalism is love for one's nation or patriotic feeling towards one's nation. When you start placing your country before you, that means you have so much of love for your country that you are ready to sacrifice yourself for the country. So that is your nationalism. So France में somewhere around 1789 revolutionary ideologies का birth हुआ, means revolutionary ideas आए. लोगों ने decide किया कि अब हमें monarchy को give up कर sovereignty को establish कराना चाहिए. So basically people wanted to lay the foundation of such a society where nobody enjoyed privileges or were discriminated on the basis of their birth. That means if you remember in our previous video we have discussed the social structure of France before French Revolution, how your first two state, that was first state and second state, clergy and nobility, how they enjoyed all the privileges and had no responsibilities, whereas your third state had to take care of all the financial matters, that means they had to pay all the taxes. So they wanted to give up such a form of government that discriminated people on the basis of their birth. So revolutionaries ने काफी ideas inculcate किए थे. They wanted people to come together for their country. So they gave them a common identity. So always remember that if you are calling somebody or if you are asking people to come together, you need to give them a common identity. पहले उन लोगों को identify कराना पड़ता है, that how you people are same. If for example, I'll give you a very current example of your cricket matches, as I know you have very keen interest in cricket. So if I ask with you that which is your favorite team in IPL, so you have variety of answers. You some of you will say Mumbai, some of you will say Bangalore, some of you will say Hyderabad. So this is how I'm dividing you on the basis of state boundaries. On the basis of state, I'm dividing you. But if I ask that which is your favorite team as whole, so immediately you will come together to support your Indian cricket team. So this is how I'm giving you a common identity as calling you all as Indians. So at that time, a common identity, how was the common identity given to the people? So the term La Patrie. La Patrie was, what was La Patrie? So it was the fatherland. How we refer our country as motherland, they refer to their country as fatherland. So the common identity first way was that they were given the idea of La Patrie. That means this country is your fatherland and you all belong to it. And what were they called as? Les citoyens. That means you all are the citizen of this country. If you are born and brought up in the country, irrespective of any division, you all belong to this country. You are the les citoyen of this La Patrie. Means you are the citizen of this fatherland. So they were given various changes. So at that time various changes were brought by the revolutionaries. They discarded the royal flag, the earlier royal flag that was used or that was very prevalent during the monarchical phase was discarded, and they adopted a new tricolor flag. So the new hymns were composed, oaths were taken and martyrs were commemorated. So जिन्होंने अपने देश के लिए सैक्रिफाइस किया था उन लोगों को याद किया गया, उन लोगों के सैक्रिफाइस को एक्नॉलेज किया गया. सो न्यू असेंबली वॉज इलेक्टेड एंड दैट असेंबली वॉज कॉल्ड एज नेशनल असेंबली. सो वट वॉज इट कॉल्ड एज नेशनल असेंबली. दिस नेशनल असेंबली डिड नॉट कैटेगराइज पीपल इन टू एनी स्टेट, रादर एवरीबडी वॉज इक्वल. सो यूनिफॉर्म लॉज वर अडॉप्टेड. French regional dialects were discouraged because at that time revolutionaries, what they felt was that regional dialects would divide people on the basis of language. So regional dialects were discouraged, and as French was spoken or French was commonly spoken in Paris, the French became the common language of the people. So it was not that the French ideas or the ideologies of French revolutionaries were confined to France. Rather, it started spreading to the various, or it reached to the various or different countries of Europe. So people, nobody is happy when somebody is ruling them, not governing them, but rather ruling them. So people of various cities, what they started doing is middle class people, they started setting up Jacobins club. Now, what was Jacobins club? Jacobins club, basically you can say a society where people were encouraged to fight for their country. They were encouraged to go against the current form of government, that was monarchical form of government, and to establish democracy or sovereignty where people would or everybody would be treated equally. So this was all about your first page or your first topic, that is the French Revolution and the idea of nation. So some key points I have already jotted down here that you can write down in your copies. French Revolution 1789, transfer of sovereignty from monarchy. La patrie and les citoyens, concept of la patrie and les citoyens were given to the people. Equal rights, that means a national assembly, the newly elected assembly, that was national assembly, treated everybody equally. New French flag, that means the royal flag was discarded and the new French flag was adopted. State generals, after elections of state general elections, the national assembly was elected. Uniform laws was adopted. And French language, that means French was was treated as the main language or the common language of the people. The regional dialects were discouraged. So this was all about this topic. Further topic we'll discuss in the next video. Thank you.